righty.
What a nice crowd tonight. I'm having a great day, I'll just be very honest about it. All right? Started the day with a bacon, egg, and cheese. Right? Right, then, right? Doesn't that just make you smile when you say that? In fact, if you're ever taking pictures and you're having trouble smiling, just say bacon, egg, and cheese. I'm telling you, you're gonna have a great smile. But when I order it, here's what I do. I have a special way of ordering it when I'm at the deli. I say to the lady, let me get a bacon, egg, and cheese, and make it nice. You guys know what make it nice means, right? That's fat man code for put a lot on it. In other words, put some bacon on the bacon, egg, and cheese. Okay? Make it nice. See, I'm a light sleeper. I just wake up heavy. When I was a kid, I don't know if you guys had this when you were a kid, my mother used to measure how big I got by putting pencil marks on the kitchen wall. You remember that? She's like, first grade, second grade, third grade. I got even with her ass, though. When she was visiting the last time, I put her up against the wall. I said, Ma, remember when you were 60? Remember when you were 65? Now look at you. Now look at you. I tried that juice diet. This is the part where I'm gonna do some fat jokes, okay, folks? This is my fat joke riff. Anyway, I tried a juice diet. Have you tried that? That's not easy. Not easy. I said to the lady at the counter at the juice bar, let me get a medium-sized roast beef and juice. And put it in a sippy cup for me. Because there's nothing more I enjoy than walking through the streets of Manhattan slurping down some roast beef and juice. My wife said to me, why don't you join the gym? And I'm like, I'm just going to talk to a guy named Jim. Let me know. How he's into it. I am, I don't know if anyone else here has been training, but I've been training for the upcoming marathon. Not to run it, to watch it. You know, my easy chair, five Kenyans going through the burrows. It's going to be nice. But I think maybe I think I'm going to ease into that whole exercise thing. Just walking, not running, walking. And then you hear people say that thing, I don't know if you've heard this, you're so clumsy you can't even walk and chew gum at the same time. My answer to those people is, who wants to? When I want to chew gum, and I mean really chew gum, I set aside a nice chunk of time. Like Tuesday afternoon, you know? I go to the corner, I get some juicy fruit, I come home, I dim the lights, I slip into something comfortable, that's right. And for the next 2 hours, it's me and the bubblegum. It ain't nobody's business if I do. If I do, well, facts while we're there. Yeah, so we're in Times Square, right? And I was walking here, and this kid with a clipboard comes up to me and says, do I have a moment for Greenpeace? And I'm like, look, I'd like to stay and chit-chat, but I'm running late for a whale roast. I'm running late for a whale roast. What do you think about these changes now in Times Square? What do you think about it? The whole Disney-fication, they like to say that, right? Yeah, you're not sure about that. I kind of miss the days of those mom and pop sex shops. Remember those? Remember those mom and pop sex shops? Listen, I can't pay for that dildo. Can I do it next week? Man, don't worry about it. I knew your father. Get out of here. Get out of here. Of course, I hope everyone's practicing safe sex, right? masturbation in a good neighborhood. That's why I'm always happy to see the guardian angel. You know what I mean? It's nice. It's sad. So, I'll tell you a little more about myself. Not bragging or anything, but I live on the 39th floor of a 40-story walk-up. 1.5 bathroom apartment. That's right. That's the whole thing. No. You walk in the front door, you're standing in the bathroom. Side door, half a bathroom. But I stay very clean, and that's important. Bathrooms. What about public bathrooms? Right? Yeah, it's always a little. Have you been inside any of these public bathrooms with the automatic flush?
Yeah.
Don't take the flush away from me. Allow me the chance to review. That's all I'm saying. It's my right as an American, isn't it? You go to other countries, you know, they don't have that right. They don't have it in other countries. You're proud to be an American. What about all these debates? You getting ready for the third debate? Yeah. You know what? I like debates so much. I think they should make all jobs. Like if you want to work at McDonald's, have a debate. Right? You know, I am the only person on this stage tonight who knows how to work a fry machine. I will make McDonald's great again. We will build a wall around Taco Bell and keep those gordita-eating rapists the hell out. Those gordita-eating rapists. Jot that down. But, you know who I was secretly voting for, though? We're going for. Can you tell me? Yeah. Chris Christie. Yeah. I don't mind saying it. We need a fat president, is what I'm trying to say. No more of these presidents with skinny presidents and nice haircuts. I want a president with a 50-inch waist, goddammit. Who knows what diabetes is? You know what I mean? Who's gonna understand what I'm saying? The country's in a lot of problems, right? A lot of problems. Have you heard about this? I can't quite tell. What about the United States copper penny? Have you heard about that? It now costs 1.5 cents to make the 1 cent penny. Have you heard that?
Yes.
It's just bizarre. When I heard that on the news, I got scared because I think I misheard it. I thought they were going to stop making the penny. The pasta, the penny. I went to Whole Foods and I got 35 boxes of penne. Was that? Yeah, you're right. All right,
last thing. Because we got one or two more comics, great comics. Give me a chance here. What about Starbucks? You guys like the Starbucks? Yeah.
I don't know, lately, Starbucks has been having like a little bit of an attitude, I get a sense. You know, like last week I was in there and I said to the lady, let me get a medium coffee with milk. And she said, the milk is behind you, over there, like pointing over there, telling me. And I said, you know, for $3.50, I want you to breastfeed my coffee. make it frothy for daddy. In other words, make it nice.
All right, everybody, clap it up.